goodness.
Okay.
2 seconds.
Yes. Okay.
So welcome to the Open Document Editor's Dev Room. We can start with the first presentation by imacat. It's going to be a funny one, so we start on a bright note.
Okay, thank you. I'm glad to know that there's someone welcoming you, so I don't have to welcome you myself. Okay, and before we begin, anyone still playing Pokémon Go now? Oh, that's cool. Okay, I'll show you a short story. Hopefully I can make it short. And one of my friends, she went to interview for a new job, and the interviewer asked her a question, saying, this position requires a persistent character, and can you show your persistency? And then she turned up her cell phone and said, look, I'm still playing Pokémon Go. Yes, I'm persistent, and you are persistent too. And okay, some introduction of, let me introduce myself. I'm from Taiwan and open source office, LibreOffice community. And I'm a member of the Apache Open PMC. Also, I'm a member of the Women in Force in Taiwan. And besides that, well, I'm a game player for almost 3 decades. Yeah, that reveals my age. I'm from MS DOS to Windows 95, 98. Now I'm playing Linux Steam. And PC game, I play PC game, MUD, MUD. Have anyone heard of MUD? MUD? Yeah, wow, that's cool. Okay. Did I know you? Okay, cool. We or mobile games. And my favorite game genre is always RPG role-playing games. And, well, okay. All in all, it started as a spreadsheet. You know, a spreadsheet is actually a very convenient place to store the information because you don't have to worry about the metadata, the data size, data type, or precision, anything. So I use spreadsheet to store all kinds of data information. For example, the journal account, including the account of my this travel. And also the student scores, I use those record student scores or the attendees list. And this is also true when it comes to games. Since I play a game a lot, I also create a lot of spreadsheets to store game data. For example, the Ultima 7, anyone heard of this? Anyone heard of this? Wow, that's cool. Okay. It also reveals my age again. And as part to the servant tile, the lost items of the main character, I use it to recall what item is lost and what it is replaced, and the clue how to find it. And to come to a closer age, plants versus zombies, I use it to recall the plants, their cause, and their genre. And also, this is a Chinese game, Sanctuary Battle. I used to recall all the heroes I got, and this tree is amazing. It's just amazing. Now it goes for Pokémon Go. In Pokémon Go, every Pokémon has its combat power. I believe many of you have not already know. And we often compare Pokémon by their combat power. For example, you see the Charmander is 500 and the Squirtle is 400. It's apparently stronger. And some species are just stronger than the others. For example, the Krabby above is just stronger than the male Nidoran below. And even within the same species, their CP may still be different. So they are still different from one another. So Pokémon of the same species share the same set of base stats. For example, you can see that for Pikachu, its base attack is 112, and the defense is 101, and stamina is 70. And the snowball below is much stronger. Its attack is 177, defense 194, and stamina is 190. And in addition to these base stats, there are still also individual values. And individual values are added to the base stats and range from 0 to, there are three values range from 0 to 15. And also, there's level. Pokemon has their level, and this level is indicated by arc, the arc below the CP. So you can see that these two bar peaks, the one above is of level 20, and the one below is of value 25. It's, yeah, and the R is longer. So level can be advanced by power up, and each power up advances the level by half. So in order to get the strongest Pokemon, we first choose the strong species that with high base set. And for Pokemon of that species, we pick the Pokemon with the highest individual values. And then we power up to a maximum to get the, to advance its level. So now the question is, how do we get know their individual values? Actually, individual values are hidden. The Pokemon company won't let us to know. If you peek into the individual values, you'll be banned from the game. So, but we are hackers, you know. We can still calculate it from hints and clues. Okay, actually there are several websites that calculate Pokemon individuals for you. For example, for this Squeaky Puff, you can see that its CP is 472, and its, well, it's not quite clear, its HP is 162. And to power, it takes 4,000 stardust and 3 candies. So let's see. If we got Jigglypuff and 472, 162, and 4,000. And yes, we haven't powered it up yet. And then calculate. We got 8 possible combinations. Okay. Then we further limit the result. By the team leader's appraisal. For me, I'm in a red team. The team leader, yes? Yeah, red team. Yeah. Okay, Team Valor. The Team Valor says overall Magikarp is strong Pokemon, you should be proud. And then it says its HP is stronger than strongest feature. And I'm just impressed with its attack. And it's got excellent stats. How exciting. So let's go back to here. Team Valor appraisal. First choose the Team Valor and strong Pokemon. My HP is strongest feature. I got impressed as its attack, and it got excellent stats. How exciting. Well, it limits to one value. It's 25, 14, A14. Okay. With this online calculator, With this online calculator, I actually created a more advanced spreadsheet to score. Oh, sorry. I actually created a spreadsheet to recall all my strongest Pokemons. Yeah. That's the crazy thing I do. I did. I always did something like this. Yeah. And, you know, I always do things that's useless. I like to hack useless things. Okay. Now, back to my slides. And also, it also tell you how strong it's possible it could possibly be. For example, the Jigglypuff buff we saw it require one. It can go to 1,800 CP and it require 174,000 stardust and 190 candies to power up. So, then I have a next question. My Lapras has the following IV. It's level, it's 20, 13, 12, 11. And to get Pokemon level 39, and it takes 200,000 stardust and 200 candies and into CP 2,800. But I only got 29 candies. So, should I power it up? And Lapras is so hard to catch, so should I power it up? And how strong it would be? And to get the answer, I have to be able to calculate the CP myself. And actually for popular game like this, someone has already hacked it. So I just do the Google and found this CP formula. Yes. And you can see that attack is base attack plus the IV attack and times the CPM. And defense is defense, base defense plus IV defense times CPM and stamina. And also CP is attack times square root of defense and square root of stamina and divided by 10. Okay? First part of the base stats. Base stats, it can be also be found on internet. Someone already found it. So also I copied it and put, I copied this table. Secondly, the CPM CP multiplier. CP multiplier is actually a list of constants increased with level. They can be found on internet too. And for half levels, they are calculated at real time using this formula. So, for example, my butterfree is base is 167, defense 151, and 120. Live is 14, 15, 9. So I apply this formula, I get a CP of 1,039. And that's exactly what I got. Okay, return to my Lapras problem. The amount of stardust and candy to power up can also be found on the internet too. So from level 20, I found that I can only get to level 25. And to level 25, apply the film, I found the CPM of level 25. I found that I can get a CP, possible CP to 2,077. Okay, that's where I'm got now. Okay, it seems worth it. It's quite strong. So using this formula, I create a more advanced spreadsheet and to tell all the possibilities of my Pokemons and how it could be. Okay. Then, with the ability to calculate the CP, actually application, the calculator is just one step away. You know, it's only simply brute force. The pseudocode is quite simple. I look through each possible level and each stamina, each attack, and each defense. And if the calculated CP is the CP I got, and then boom, I got an answer. And the result, it runs 79 times 15, times 15 times 15 to 260,000 times. That's a huge number, and it won't stop. So, but we have ways to refine it. See, if we know the stardust table, if we know the stardust, actually we can limit the number of possible levels from to only four levels. And for newly co-op Pokemons, the level will always be whole number, so it will limit to two levels. And HP is actually the stamina as a whole number. So apply this formula, I can only also limit the IV stamina to one or two values. So the number of runs is reduced to 900 times and it's a lot smaller. Now, for refinement with team leader appraisal, for a better team, the first appraisal is total stats. If it is amazed me, it gets more than 36. If it is a strong Pokemon, it goes 30 to 36. And if it is a decent Pokemon, it goes 23 to 29. But if it's not great in battle, it is less than 23. The second appraisal is best stats. And its HP is its strongest feature, and as guy is as impressed as its attack. Whatever is listed, they are equally its best stats. So, and the third appraisal is maximum stat value. And if I'm blown away by its stat, it's 15. The maximum is 15. I'm got excellent stats. It's maximum 13 or 14. If they indicate in battle, I'll get the job done. It's between 8 and 12. You won't point to greatest in battle is less than 7 than 8. So with this, let's see. The GK buff we just got here, and with a CP of 472, and HP of 162, and Stardust 4,000. And for me, my current level is 30. And it's team raider, so I got strong Pokémon. It's AP strong features, impressed with attack, and excellent how it stats, how it's sighting. Okay, and I got the result. Okay, this is done. Oh, but I see I still have 5 minutes, so let's share a short story. Sorry. One morning in November, when I woke up, I found my gyrus gets much stronger than I expected. Then I remember, it's weird. Actually, not only gyrus, everyone has changed its power. So I went to the Pokemon fan page and found this. Yeah, we have just made adjustment to a CP, and that's terrible. And it's lucky that I haven't published this calculator yet. And I quickly search the internet and find someone has already found the table. Yeah, and I immediately applied it. And that's the first story. Second story, the other day when I woke up, when I'm walking, I had something that I never seen. So I went to a Pokemon fan page again. Say, oh, new Pokemon added. Developed Togepi and Pichu from hatching from eggs. And that terrified me because this time I already published it. So I spent all my coins to hatch these Pokemons and to get their data. And for those I haven't hatched, I even asked all my friends if they have already hatched it in order to get their data. Yeah. So the lessons I learned from here. If you are creating some game hacking tool and you don't have commercial support, you had better not publish it. Because it's really a nightmare, you know, if the game change. Because if the game change, you have to update it immediately. And second lesson I learned, for strong species like Dragonite, base stats takes the largest part of the CP. You see, the attack is 263 plus 15. Defense 201 plus 15 and stamina 18.2 plus 11. Actually, Dragonite is just stronger, whatever its IV is. And the second important factor is always its level. And for IV, we are calculating, it doesn't really matter. Okay? Thank you very much. Any question? Yes?
Where's the site?
Where can we find it? Oh, yes, I forgot it. Just actually, you can get from here. I put it on GitHub. That's another topic I'll talk about it this afternoon. I put it on GitHub. And also, currently, I only put it. I still not put it on. Sorry. Yeah, I still haven't put it on the LibreOffice extension yet. But I check and just it runs smoothly on LibreOffice too. Yeah. Maybe I'll just upload it later. Yes. Any question? No question? Then I hope you enjoy this. Thank you. You're next.
I'm just checking. Everybody's got everything.
Don't leave! We still have sessions. Don't leave this room. We still have sessions.
I'm just checking that the sound of everything's